During the Nyege Nyege festival last year, Justice David Batema, the executive officer at Itanda Falls Experience Company, an entity that is in charge of Itanda Falls, fenced off the Nile River shores to avoid revelers from drowning into the falls. However, since then, he refused to put off the wire mesh, an act that has infringed on the other activities that have for long been done from this area, like rafting, tubbing, and kayaking. During a meeting by the National Environment Management Authority, the tour operators accused Justice David Batema of blocking their activities by denying them access to the riverbank. Stakeholders say Justice Batema imposed a fee of 150,000 shillings monthly payment to each rafting company that uses the shores of Itanda Falls, which they contest, saying that they remit revenue to URA.
We pay taxes to URA. So we can't come and we start rafting from where we start from. All areas we move across the river in the 100-meter demarcation, like the river banks. We can't be paying everybody we find on the river. That's impossible and it can't happen. It can never happen. So at the same time, when we're doing rafting, when we reach like Itanda Falls in particular, it's a big rapid. It's running above grade 5, whereby on commercial trips we stop on grade 5. We don't run grade 6. So if we're to risk our clients on the river, to stay on the river to move on, we are going to kill clients. Okay? So we're going to kill clients, we're going to kill tourism in Uganda in particular.
Some of the aggrieved tour operators broke down to tears as they presented their case.
This is not good. I'm very sad. We've been struggling for a long time. And you NFA say that you have given him to use this land. You have given him to use the whole river. Who is owning the river? Who is owning this river? Is there anyone owning this river? Huh? Is you, Jesus, created this river? That is bad. I have a big pain on my heart. And to the locals.
Abdallah Suta, the LC3 chairperson of Butagaya sub-county, Jinja district where the falls are located, narrated on how the community has been affected by the fence erected by Justice Batema at the riverbank.
Said the chairperson, we have been blocked even from fetching water around because people have been fetching water around there. They have been blocked. He said, what is it? I approached the NFA. I said, which is this? We sat. From there, in my capacity, because I'm entrusted that we are the chairperson security, by law, these people, the adrift, the rafting companies approached me, said, this has not been. For the years you have been in office and operating with you, I approached these people. All we held a meeting there, as if we are agreeing, but we disagreed in accordance with the law.
Justice Batema noted that he fenced off the riverbank to protect the falls and the Nile River from pollution by the local communities.
I preached to them the gospel of turning this into an ecotourism center. Some agreed. Some said, we shall fight you. Gano ife getulia, enana daife, duma waife, emboli. I said I'll fight you. If you can't win me, join me.
Batema denied allegations of asking for money from licensed tour companies.
RRA, Uganda Revenue Authority, is licensed to collect taxes from me, from rafters. When you show me that you have paid for using this place, I don't tax you again, the double taxation.
National Environment Management Authority Executive Director Dr. Akankwasa Barirega has intervened in the matter. He temporarily stopped the judge from charging rafters any money until his application for maintaining the riverbank was approved by NEMA.
Rafters who are complaining of access should, through Uganda Tourism Board, send the companies to me, then I will write to Itanda Falls to exempt you for the meantime.
Story compiled by Lubega Ivan for the news.